Hello, my name is William from Pomona Self-Help. Assuming that John Doe is the litigant, let me guide you through the FL-150 Income and Expense Declaration form. This form is important because it is the document the court will use to run child support numbers. Also, keep in mind that if you are going to file something new with the court, you have to redo one of these forms if it has been over 3 months since you filled out the last one. Essentially, the court demands this because it wants up-to-date information. I want to bring to your attention that I will approach this form for general cases. If you believe your case to be atypical, please visit one of the self-help centers for assistance. Now, since there are lots of content and lines on this form, I already pre-filled out the information for John Doe. However, I'll go through each section step by step and point out a lot of the lines that are commonly missed. I hope that through this video, you will learn how to properly fill out the FL-150 form. Alright, so first fill out the captions above. By this step in the divorce process, you should have no difficulty filling out the captions. Now, lots of litigants make mistakes because they choose not to answer some of these lines and blanks. Unfortunately, I want to point out that you don't have a choice. Each line and blank is information required by the court. Remember that the court doesn't like empty lines and blanks. So, fill in each line and blank to the best of your knowledge, even if that means writing in zeros. Below for number one, write your employer information. Make sure to fill in E, the date job started. If you don't remember the exact date, just write in the month and year. That's good enough. And if you are currently unemployed, write down the information of your most recent job. If you are writing down your most recent job, don't forget to fill out F, the date job ended. Just like the date job started, fill in the date to the best of your knowledge. Below, write down your wage information and if you get paid monthly, weekly, or hourly. For John Doe, we just wrote in $13 an hour, and he works 40 hours a week. And let's move on to number two. Let's scroll down here. Right. Now for number two, write your age, 4A, and if you completed high school or not, check yes or no. For John Doe, let's say that he did graduate from high school, so we checked off the yes box. If you didn't complete high school, indicate here the highest grade completed, like 9, 10, or 11. Also, make sure to write in if you attended college or grad school. For John Doe, let's assume that he dropped out of college after 1 year, so we only put 1 here. And below, let's say that John Doe has a teaching assistant license, so we wrote that in also, right here, and checked off the appropriate box. Now for number three, fill in your tax information. Make sure to fill in D, this box right here. A lot of litigants forget to fill in the line for number of exemptions. Now, number four is an important line for child support. If you don't know how much the other party makes, write an unknown, like how we did for John Doe, here. If you do know roughly how much the other party makes per month, write in how much, here. And also write in the blank space below how you know about this amount, like the children told me, or I saw on her pay stubs, or she told me over the phone, etc. Finally, write today's date, print your name, and sign on the line to the right. And let's scroll to the second page. Right. Above, make sure to fill in the captions. Below, for number five, there are two columns. The left one represents the amount for the last 30 days. And the right one represents the average monthly amount. For our example, let's say that all of John Doe's income is from salary, wages, and overtime. So we filled in lines A and B. And filled in zeros for the rest of the lines because again, the court doesn't like blanks. Note that for overtime, we put 0 for the left line and 200 for the right line. This means that John Doe makes roughly $200 a month for overtime, but he didn't receive anything from overtime the last 30 days, so we wrote in 0 on the left line. Some other noteworthy lines are D, public assistance like TANF, SSI, or general assistance or general relief, and I is also an important line for disability, like SDI. And number 6 deals with investment income, like dividends, rental property, and trust income. And 7 deals with self-employment. Let's say that none of these apply to John Doe, so we filled in zeros for number 6 and 7. And let's scroll down here. Now, number 8 is for if you have any other additional income coming from a lump sum, like winning the lottery or receiving a will. Number 9, change in income, is for if there was a drastic change in income the last year, like unemployment or sporadic employment. Now, number 10 deals with deductions. For our example, let's say that John Doe pays $300 a month for a 401k, $50 a month for health insurance, and $20 a month for shoes and dry cleaning items. He has to pay out of his own pocket, not reimbursed by his employer. And for the record, let's write shoes and dry clean on the side. Now, number 11 deals with assets for John Doe. Let's say there is currently $500 total from all of his bank accounts. $0 for stocks and bonds. And negative $19,400 for personal property. We got this value from all of his assets minus his car, credit card, and student loans debt. And let's scroll down to the third page. Again, make sure that the captions are filled out at the top. Now for number 12, write in the box underneath, anyone else living with you. For John Doe, his 2 kids live with him, so we wrote in their names, age, their relationship to John Doe, their income, and checked off the box no for contributing to household expenses because they don't work yet. Now, for number 13, you can either check estimated expenses or proposed needs. I like to go with proposed needs for each line below. Write in how much the monthly expenses are for everyone in your household. So the values for these lines reflects the expenses for John Doe and his 2 children, so 3 people total. For instance, we just wrote in $1,200 a month for rent, $50 a month for healthcare, not paid by insurance, $150 for childcare, $250 for groceries, $200 for eating out, $50 for utilities like gas, electric, water, and trash, $100 for telephone, $40 a month for laundry, $30 a month for clothes, $300 a month for auto expenses and transportation like gas, repairs, and bus fees, $70 a month for insurance. And don't forget the lines that don't apply to us, we just put in zeros. And let's scroll down. Below, we wrote in the installment payments and debts for John Doe. You see the car, the credit card, and the student loan. So $500 plus $500 plus $700 equals $1,700. And we write in that number for letter P. And there is no one else helping John Doe pay for these expenses, so we put in 0 for S, and also 0 for the other expenses box, and the total value for A through Q in the R box, which comes out to $4,140. And let's scroll down. Skip 15 because you are self-represented. Also, skip these lines at the bottom. because there are only four if you have an attorney. And let's scroll to the last page. Make sure that the captions are filled out at the top. This page is exclusively for child support. Here, there are two minor children involved in John Doe's case, and they spend 77% of the time with him and 23% of the time with Jane D. Doe. Here you want the percentages to be as accurate as possible. And for number 17, let's say that John Doe doesn't have health insurance through his job, so we checked off this box. I do not. And let's scroll down. And for number 18, monthly additional expenses for the minor children, we put $150 for childcare, $100 for healthcare not covered by insurance, $50 for gas for visitation, and $0 for education and other special needs. Of course, these values are amounts per month. Now down here for 19, if 19 doesn't apply to you, put in zeros like we did here. And congratulations. You now know how to fill out the FL-150 Income and Expense Declaration form. Please proceed to the FL-115 Proof of Service of Summons for a Divorce video.